guys, it's Erica from Pilates to Pilates. So today we are going to kick off the spring-summer mat series. So this is going to kind of mimic the reformer series that we just did. So it's the first one that we are going to do is a traditional mat class. Okay, obviously suitable for all levels. I will give progressions and modifications for each exercise. So take it at your own pace. I'm going to keep all of these videos again similar to the reformer. Really easily attainable, and this will be a great series to, again, similar to the performer one, slot into your practice and give you a little bit of variety from traditional to toning to a bit of cardio, and it will be great to use throughout the summer for your summer holidays when you don't have access to classes and the other apparatuses to use. So I am going to use no props today. These will all be available to be done without anything. And again, as always, you can feel free to pop up ankle weight or wrist weights if you have them and you want to use them to kind of kick it up a notch. Okay, so we are actually going to start very similar to what Joseph Pilates usually did with a quick round of 100. So you're going to get the core nice and warm, start to activate the whole body, get our breath work going. So yeah, let's get started. All right, so we're going to come on down. Yourself nice and comfortable on the mat here. Okay, so as always, in your hundreds, you have a few different options. Okay, you can always just bring the legs in tabletop. You can keep the legs grounded if you need to, if you're a very beginner and find that the legs lifted are a bit too much. Feel free to come down to the floor. So beginner will be here, intermediate here. And then obviously you're advanced, your legs are extended and are as low as you possibly can get them without the back lifting and without any tension in the neck. We're going to be breathing in through the nose for 5 counts and out through the mouth for 5 counts with a continuous pulse of those arms, right? So let's roll those shoulder blades back and down, find that connection. Take your inhale, come into your position, and we start here. We're going to inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, and exhale, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Pull those knees in. Take a nice knee to the chest here. Give yourself a nice little release. Bring the knees to one side, head to the other. You got your blood flowing, got your abdominals nice and warm. Getting ready to continue on through class. Move that spine. All right, so we're going to go into roll up next. So again, my beginners can keep their knees bent and use their hands to grab onto the backs of their thighs for assistance. And my more intermediate to advanced clients, you're going to go ahead and extend those legs nice and long. Bring those arms back behind the head. So you find that nice two-way stretch here, right? So arms reaching in one direction and the toes reaching in the other, okay? Finding that length. Okay, so take a nice inhale and exhale. Okay, and then from here, we're gonna inhale to prepare and bring the arms up just above the shoulders. On our exhale, we're taking our chin to our chest, bringing the crown of the head forward, and reaching up and over, coming parallel to those legs, and then slowly tucking that navel into the spine and coming down as slow as we can, vertebrae by vertebrae, coming all the way back into that nice long line. So from here, we take our inhale, feel back side and belly, exhale, arms come up, chin comes to chest, reach, think of lifting up and over that big beach ball here, through the crown of the head, feel someone pulling those arms to the opposite side of the room, and then slowly coming all the way back down. And let's go a few more here. Inhale. option to just pull that tummy back.
Then reach, 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 reach.
And then slow back down. We're going to go two more here. Okay, so as I said before, if you need to, you keep the knees slightly bent. Okay, you could do your roll from here. Inhale, exhale, you could grab onto the backs of those thighs. And reach. Okay, this is a nice modified little set here. And just focusing on the rounding of that spine, staying in that nice E curve and finding that articulation. Okay, still working quite well. So take an inhale, exhale. Hold that.
Reach, 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 reach.
And all the way back down here. And last one. Inhale. Nice and tall. through the crown of the head here. And we're going to go into a little bit more movement for the back, some more rotation work. So we're going to start off with a little spine twist. So getting some rotation. Okay, so you can either have your hands just crossed across the chest here. All right, and then if you wanted to make it a bit more advanced, you could take the arms fully out nice and wide. All right, so if you start here, we're going to sit up nice and tall. We're going to start twisting to the left. So we're going to take an inhale in. And then exhale, rotate through that spine, look over that left shoulder. Release the air from the lungs. And then inhale, come back center. And then exhale, we're going to rotate to the right. So everything stays fully center, okay? Our hips are still, and we're just rotating through the spine here. Okay, so again, if you want to go a bit more advanced, we're going to keep the arms out, shoulder height. Okay, take an inhale, exhale. Still following the gaze of that hand. And come back center. And then exhale. And each side. Inhale. So notice that everything's still. I'm just rotating from the torso. Okay. And again, exhale. Trying to go a bit further each time. And again, exhale. And then last time. And come back center here and drop everything. Okay, so again, if you needed to, you can cut the knees a little bit bent on those. If your hamstrings are tight, that's fine. And it's the same thing for the next one. Okay, so if your hamstrings are a little tight, you're going to do this one a bit more modified with the legs up. Otherwise, you can keep them down. We're going to go into a bit of squat. So now we've warmed up through that rotation. We're going to add a little bit of a reach, okay? So from here, we're going to go into squat. Arms are going to come out to the side for this one. We're going to take an inhale. On the exhale, we're going to twist. Hold that rotation. Same thing we just did in our spine twist. And now we're going to exhale. You're going to take that pinky on the right hand, and you're going to reach it towards the outside of that left toe. Okay? And then we're going to go one, two, trying to go a little further. Three, keeping those hips still, keeping that right sit bone planted. And then come back up. And come center. Take an inhale, exhale, twist. Now we're gonna reach, bring that left pinky forward to the outside of that right foot and reach, looking back at that right hand and reach. Now keeping that left sit bone down and then come center. Okay, so modify what we can do here. Okay, take an inhale, slightly bend the arms, exhale, twist and reach. Still crown of the head moving. Reach, pull that tummy back, reach. Reach and lift. Come center. Inhale. Exhale. Reach. 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 And come center. Okay, let's finish it off here. Two more times. One more each side. Exhale. Come down. Two, three, and lift. Nice work. And we come across. Down. Reach. Reach and lift. Okay, nice work. Roll everything out here. We're going to just come down. We're going to do our ab series now. So again, keeping this a little bit more traditional today. So we are going to start off, we're going to go single leg stretches. All right, so if at any time you have any tension in the neck, just go ahead, keep it down, and you can do the other movements, okay? So from here, we are going to bring the legs into tabletop, okay? Imprint that spine here. Okay, pull the belly in, curl the head, neck, and shoulders off. Okay, looking down at the tummy, at the thighs. We're gonna reach the right knee in and change left knee in, okay? So one leg extends, one bends. We're gonna inhale, inhale, exhale, exhale. Inhale, inhale, exhale, exhale. Two more. And last one, okay, you can come down, reset if
otherwise stay lifted, we're going right into double legs. So we're reaching the arms outside, knees are to nose, and then finding that nice two-way stretch, reaching arms, reaching toes, exhale, bring knees to nose. Again, inhale, and bring it all together here. Inhale. Let's go for it. For three. For two. Last one. From here, hands come behind the head. Interlink those fingers. Let the head lay heavy in the palms, thump down the back of the neck. Legs lifted, heels together, toes apart. Slight bend if you need to, otherwise extended, activating and wrapping those inner thighs here. We're gonna go lift the bummers. Take an inhale lower. Only come down as far as you can without that low back lifting. Exhale, scoop that belly and come up without the tail lifting. So you find that range of motion. Inhale, exhale, no tension in that neck. Push the head heavy into those palms. Let the abdominals do all the work here. Inhale it down. Exhale, lift. Let's go four more. Inhale down. And exhale, lift. For three. For two. And last one. Bring it up here. Take the hands. We're going to go right into our scissors. So we drop the left leg, lift the right knee to nose, pull two. And change. Keep those toes pointed. Find that reach. And reach, no rocking. Pull that tummy in. Keep those shoulders plugged down. Away from those ears. Breathing here. Breathe through. You've got four. Three. For two. And one. Bring it in. We're going to finish with our crisscross hands back behind the head. Opposite elbow. Opposite knee. Think opposite shoulder. Opposite knee. Opposite rib. Opposite hip. Okay, coming up and over. Reaching. Give me four. For three. For two. And last one. Nice work. Pull those knees in. Release it. Okay, we're going to even out after that abdominal work and do some back extension. Okay? So you can just roll over. I'm going to come to the front so you can see me a little bit better. So I'll come this way. Just move this. All right, we're going to go into some back extension prep. All right, so we're going to get the feet about as wide as the mat. So legs a little bit wide here. We're going to bring the palms down and bring them almost in line with the shoulders here. Okay, now forehead comes down. Okay, so everything's nice and relaxed. Pelvis is slightly tucked, pubic bone is pushing down into the mat. Okay, from here, we're going to take an inhale and exhale, breathe. Okay, again, inhale, keeping those shoulders plugged down away from the ears, shoulder blades gliding towards my bottom. So just finding that setup here. Okay, and now we're going to continue. As we inhale, we're going to lift everything off the mat and then exhale, come back down. So inhale, everything lifts, elbows, forearm, hands, forehead, and exhale, everything releases back to the mat. Let's go a few more times like this. Inhale. And exhale. And inhale. And exhale. If this is too much, you can feel free to do this modified, just lifting, keeping the forearms planted. Okay, this is also really nice for the lower back. Right? Otherwise, we're here. We're going to go a few more, and then we're going to layer on. And again, if the layer is too much, you come back to your start, your prep work here. And lift. All right. And now from here, we're going to add on. So we're going to take our inhale. We're going to reach the arms, bend the arms, and lower. Inhale, reach, and exhale, lower. Again, if that's too much, you just stay with the lift. You don't need to do the extension of the arms. If you're
doing the extension of the arms. You're keeping those shoulders plugged down away from those ears, right? So nothing else is moving. Just have that reach.
Let's go two more.
Reach.
And last one.
And reach. Nice work. Come on down.
Okay, let's come into a little child's pose here.
Little child's pose.
Let the back rest. Okay, let everything just melt into the mat.
And then we're going to lie it back down here. Okay, and we're going to go into some bridges. So we're going to come all the way back down, lie on your back here. And we're going to keep the feet underneath the knees here. Okay. And we are going to start with some pelvic tilts. So we're going to tilt the pelvis and tuck. So we arch the back and imprint. Arch and imprint the spine. So nice little kind of tucks and arches here, reaching and releasing. Now I want you to stay in that nice imprint, okay? So sit bones facing the wall, tummy pulled in. If you want to make this more challenging, you can keep the arms up just over the shoulders. Otherwise, arms are down by the side. Okay, I want you to keep all your weight in your heels here. Take an inhale, exhale, start to activate those hamstrings and glutes and lift yourself all the way up into that nice shoulder bridge where we have shoulder, hip, and knee in one straight line. And then we slowly come down and articulate till that tailbone touches. And then we exhale, lift all the way back up. Inhale slowly, try and come down through all those sticky spots in the spine, releasing vertebrae by vertebrae. And again, exhale, come all the way up. Squeeze, wrapping and squeezing up the top here. And then inhaling, slowly lower down. A few more. Exhale, lift. And lower.
Four more. Exhale. lower.
Lift.
Lower. Shh. Give me five. Shh. For four. Shh. For three. Shh. For two. Last one. Woo! Bring it down. And then slowly come all the way down. Nice work. Let's take a quick little figure four stretch here. Take that right foot over the left knee. Push that right knee away from you. And then change. Bring that right foot down. Left knee. Left foot crosses right knee. All right. We're going to finish off this set with a little roll over here. So I think I'm in for eight. I'm just going to dump this bench in case I'm out. All right. So for my beginners, okay, you can actually just take your hands down and you're going to just practice your little rocks, your knee tucks, almost little reverse curls here. Okay, exhaling, bringing the knees back towards the nose and using your hands for support. Okay, and then you're going to try and work that range of motion as much as you can. If you feel a bit more confident, you can try and go into the full roll over here. Okay. And from here, we're going to bring the legs up. So you can start with the legs. So more intermediate, you can start with the legs fully lifted. If you want to go a bit more advanced, you're going to bring them out as far as you can without the back lifting. Okay, then we're going to take our inhale. On our exhale, we're going to reach up and over. Okay? And from here, we're going to open those legs into a nice little V. Flex those toes. And then slowly roll down. Vertebrae by vertebrae. All the way down, using those abdominals. And all the way down, bringing those feet back together. Inhale, exhale, lift. Okay, so reaching those toes, opposition here. Flex, find that stretch through the back side of the legs. Open the legs out into that V position and slowly come all the way back down, lengthening through that spine. Pointing those toes, come center. Let's go one more time. Inhale, exhale. Flex those feet. Open into your V. And we're going to come all the way back down. We're going to reverse it here. So keep those legs in that V. Point those toes. Inhale, exhale, scoop. Use those abdominals to lift. Come all the way over. Flex those toes. Bring those feet and bring the legs together now. And come all the way down. Knees connected. Point those toes. Bring it down. Take an inhale. Exhale. Shoo. Open the legs out. I did that with backwards, didn't I? Legs are closed and lower here. Right? So now we come open into our V. We reach in our V here. There we go. Up center. And release. Come down. I think we've got one more since I screwed that one up. Legs open into our V. Come over. Point. And lower all the way down here. Nice work. All right. Let's roll on to our right side. We're going to do a little sideline series to finish. Okay. So we're going to, you can either stay on your forearm here. Okay, you just want to make sure that you lift through your right oblique. Otherwise, you can come all the way down, prop your head up, or lie it all the way down. You can also place a ball underneath the head if that's more comfortable for your neck. Okay. Most important, I want your hip stacked. So I want your left hip on top of the right. All right, and then you can have the bottom leg, right leg is gonna be slightly bent for support, okay? And you're gonna bring that left leg just slightly forward here, okay? We're gonna support with that left hand if you need to, and we're gonna go into some lifts and lowers. So I want you to point that left toe, find that length. So as I find that length, I automatically lift from my right oblique. So I'm activating that bottom oblique. Okay, we're gonna go lift and lower here. We're gonna inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Inhale to lift. And exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. So these are nice, slow, controlled movements. We're gonna be up for two. And it's a hover down. Coming, bring that toe towards the floor. Inhale, reach. So really focusing on that stability here. Okay.
working through that side, finding that length, slow, controlled movements here. Still activating my oblique. We're going to go two more. And then last one, hold it up. Little lifts up for 10, 9. Keep that left hip forward. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! And give yourself a little pat if you need to. You can go into our rainbows here, so little lifts up and over. So again, extend that left leg, find that length in your side. And we're going to take an inhale, bring that foot to the front of the mat. Okay, on the exhale, we're going to try and reach the back of the mat without moving. Okay, so fully stabilized here, core pelvis. Okay, hips nice and still. Use that hand for support. If you can't come, you only go back as far as you can, I should rephrase that, so that you're not kind of wiggling around. It's not about how far forward you get your foot or how far back you get your foot. It's all about that control and stabilization. Okay? So exhale, lifting up and over, and come back. And reach. And back. Good. Reach. And back. And reach. And back. Last two. And last one. Keep the leg center. Point the toe. Bring the leg hip height. Again, we're reaching it toward that wall, keeping that oblique slightly lifted. You've got 10 circles in each direction, teeny tiny ones. Trying to grow longer from that hip socket each time. Go for 3, 2, 1, and reverse it here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Give yourself a little pat on that left side here. Okay, so to get to the other side, we're just going to roll onto our tummy, and we're going to transition with a push-up set. All right, so feel free to do these modified on your knees if you need to. All right, and we are going to slide our shoulders just over our wrists. Drop the shoulders down in the back. Tummy pulls up and in. Neck is in line with the spine, so you're gazing just down at the mat. Okay, so you're either on your knees or you're going to curl your toes up and come into that nice, beautiful plank. And then from here, we're going to go down two counts, up two counts. Inhaling and exhale, lift. We've got 10. You've got this. Only one set, so make it count. Inhale, exhale, lift. Almost there. You've got 5. For 4. For 3. For 2. And last one. And sit it back into your child's pose here. Release.
You got to finish off your right leg on your left side now. Okay.
So you could roll over here onto your left. I'm going to turn this way to face you. All right, so again, same concept applies. You can lie the head fully down. You can prop the head up. You could also keep the bottom leg extended if you wanted to make it a little more challenging. Okay, I'm gonna keep the left leg bent, bottom leg bent, right hip forward, stacked nicely, bringing that right foot slightly forward, placing the right hand down. We're going to go into those lower lifts. So we're going to lift up and exhale. So we're reaching that toe now toward the opposite wall, engaging that left oblique, and lift, lower. Nice work. Lift it up, exhale, and lower. Almost there, guys. You guys are doing great. So four more here. Good. And then last one. Okay, we're gonna come back down to hip height, that ankle's in line with the hip. Now I'm gonna take that right foot towards the front edge of the mat. Tap the toe and then reach towards the back end of the mat as far as I can, keeping my hips stacked and still. Inhale, exhale, reach, 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 reach through that side. Keep plugging through the center here. So keeping nice and stable through your center. Nice work, we're almost there. You guys are doing great. Good, exhale, reach. Always, if you like any of the activewear, feel free to check out the links below. And I-